Hey everyone, Hans here. Today, another quick video, this time on building a data set that someone requested in my mastermind. I told them I will build on a data set in return for testimonial. And now I'm recording the how-to on building a data set that has that contains startups of 10 to 20 employees, is within Europe or the UK, B2B SaaS, average order value of over 5K, first-time founders, they don't have sales executives, a growing headcount in the last 6 months, and a funding round in the last 6 months of over $1 million. That's the data set we're building today. I'm excited to show you how we did it. Let's dive in. Now, I can imagine it went a little bit quick for the viewers at home. So again, here's what we're building. It's a data set of startups with 10 to 20 employees within these regions right here. They have to be B2B SaaS. The average order value has to be over 5K. He had some suggestions on how we can look for that, and I just remember those suggestions. These people have to be first-time founders, no sales executives, so they don't have a head of sales, VP of sales, etc. on their team. Growing headcount in the last 6 months and funding round in the last 6 months of over $1 million USD. Now let's start at the beginning. So for those of you who aren't familiar with how you would start building a list of first-time founders, first-time CMOs, first-time CTOs, etc., etc. What you do is you start in Sales Navigator, where you have the current job title, which is founder, owner, co-founder in this case. And then you go to past job title, you put in the same job title, but you exclude them, which means that the past job title cannot contain co-founder, founder, owner, etc., etc. And then you add your other criteria, so they have to be in Europe and the UK, etc., etc. And that is the list that you're going with. So we have over 1 million first-time founders in the Europe and UK, if we're just going with a really broad search. So that is a search that we went with. We narrowed it down a little bit based on headcount, and also industries, just to start out with a bit more of a narrow list. So we did internet and software, I think, or information technology, just to have a more narrow list. And then that left us with this list right here. It's just simple. I would use Phantom Buster to get the full list, but this is a good starting point. So we then have these companies right here that we know more or less fit our criteria. And then we just really basically went with a prompt on their company description, which is not the most accurate way of going about it, but it's good enough for now just to get us closer. And we can just see, okay, if all the other criteria are true and it's likely to be a SaaS company, then that's fine. If you want higher accuracy, then stay tuned, because I'm releasing another video later this week with a really exciting new tool that I found that will help you do that. For now, based on the company description, we are determining using AI, using GPT, whether that company is a software as a service company or not. So it gives a true or a false. So if false, then we exclude that company. Then we use ClayGent, where we're basically saying, okay, go to this company website, look at any links, buttons, or menu items that allow visitors to book a call or sales demo with the sales team of this company. If you are able to locate this option, output 1. If you are unsure, not able to locate the option, output 0. So we get a 1 or a 0, 1 equals true. Do not provide any reasoning, do not provide any other text in your output. So then we get ones or zeros, one being a good fit for us, because, if they're sales led, then they're likely to be, their average customer or average order value is going to be higher than 5K. Bit of an assumption. We could add, or we should probably add, an additional layer where we're saying, okay, can we find their pricing? We can go to Capterra, to G2, to all those pages, and then find out their pricing there. That would be an additional layer, but I feel that if we add all of these different layers, then we get close enough to this list being good enough for the initial delivery. But again, if you want to be a lot close to 100% sure about pricing, then definitely add additional layers like G2, Capterra, other sites that might have pricing information. Then You want to check how if they have like a VP of sales or a head of sales. That's very straightforward, with zero being good, anything above zero not being good. And then this is their headcount growth. And then they give you options within Claim where you can check like the growth over the last 3, 6, 9, 12, etc. months. So we went with 6 months and then negative growth, not good. Anything above zero is good. The higher, the better, obviously. Then another thing that we needed to do is get funding data. Now you can use Clay credits for that and get the funding data, but that would not be any fun, would it? So instead, what we did is we checked for other sources to get the funding data, like Crunchbase. You get it in some cases, but they also like blur it out sometimes because, you know, they are no fun. ZoomInfo, they don't always have it. And so what I mean by that is we're looking for pages like this one, like the Pittsburgh pages, and they have that. So they use these pages for like programmatic SEO, and we're able to then scrape those where they have like a really nice FAQ for us. And they have how much funding has WeBoard raised over time. WeBoard has raised $423,000. They don't give you there the last time, but I'm pretty sure they have it here. There we go. So their seed round was in 2022. And on 25th of May, they went through an accelerator / incubator. So we can get this info as well. So they do blur out this, but then again, they have it in here, right? So all in all, this page gives us all the information that we need. And how we found that page is we basically said, let's search Google, and we use a tool called Serper.dev, which is a lot cheaper than spending Clay credits on it. And we had to put together a search. Now, Clay sometimes is a little bit tricky when passing dynamic variables through an API. So we put together the search query using a formula. So this is the search query where we're basically saying site, which means only look in this site. So pittsburgh.com/profile/company. And within that, you know, that structure, that site, look for company domains. So instead of saying, well, look for WeBoard company name, it could be the companies have a very similar name. We want to make sure that we're, you know, getting the right, like an actual match. So we look for the website, which they mentioned on here in the same structure we have. So www.weboard.me. And we have the exact same structure so that we know, okay, if we found that page, then we know for sure that it's the same company. So we put that together. That is a search that we're running. And then we get the organic results, which has the actual page that we want to scrape. That's great. And then what we do, we have that page. So we have the Pittsburgh company profile page for all the companies in here, or for, you know, all the companies that have one in here. And then what we do is we run a tool called Firecrawl. So they have their, you know, let's say basic API, and they also released another tool that I already mentioned earlier that I'm going to tell you more about later this week. But for now, Firecrawl is pretty similar to Zenrose, that they give you, you know, you give them a website and they give you the website in the website content in Markdown format. So you just get all the text from the website, right? So here you have all the text from that website, which is great because then we can use GPT or whatever your model is to then basically ask questions about that text, or use formulas to extract data from that text. So that's what we're going to do. So we said, okay, we have these Pittsburgh company profile pages. Let's use a scraper to scrape all the text from those profile pages. And then we're going to ask questions to that text. In our case, we went with a formula, basically, you know, a regular expression where we're saying, find this question in the FAQ. So it will find this question. And the reason why I'm doing it this way, because every company page has a different amount of questions. So some, they have only like 3 or 4 questions, other have 10. So I cannot say, okay, from the output in the FAQ, I will grab the 4th question. right? There's also an option when you're using a different scraper. You just say, okay, here's the FAQ, fourth question, that's the column I'm going with. Cannot do that because there's always a different amount of questions, so you don't know if your answer is in the fourth or in the 10th or the fifth question. So that is why we need to just grab the entire text of the website or FAQ section and then, you know, use regular expression to extract the right question for us. So how much funding has X, so company name, raised over time? And then they will give us the answer right here. So has raised 5.x million, almost 50 million, almost 6 million, et cetera, et cetera. So now we also have the funding information. Another question we could ask is, when was their, let's say, where is it? So Weibo valuation and funding, like what was the date of their last deal? And then we can see if it was within the last year or not, the last 6 months or not. So that would be another question we could ask, but that would again be adding another layer on top. So that's how we built the data set of startups, 10 to 20 employees. We got that from LinkedIn, Europe or UK, got that from LinkedIn. First time founders, we got that from LinkedIn. Then we used AI to determine whether or not they're B2B SaaS or likely to be B2B SaaS. Then we used, logic, I suppose. So we detect, use ClayGen to detect if they have a book a demo option. If they do, they're likely to be sales led. They're likely to have a higher average order value. Then we used Clay to determine whether or not they have a head of sales or VP of sales on their team. Then the same goes for growing headcount. We use Clay to determine whether or not their headcount was growing over the last 6 months. And then we use some custom scraping to get the latest funding round so that we would not spend Clay credits and that we would have some fun in the process as well. And you will potentially learn something from this video. So we got this information. Here's the data set that we have. It's a small sample of just, 400 companies. But now it's just a matter of using Fence and Buster to get all the data out of SalesNav, getting into here, and Clay will automatically run all of this for us. So, doing this for 400 companies will cost us exactly as much time and effort as doing it for 4,000 or 400,000. So that's how we build a data set. Hope you learned something. Hope you find it useful. If you did, I would love to hear that from you. Either way, hope to see you in the next video. Have a good one.